As we discussed in the previous video, carefully and responsibly raising monarchs can be an educational and rewarding project in the formal or non-formal classrooms or even at home. However, taking this endeavor even further through monarch tagging can contribute to monarch research and citizen science efforts. Monarch tags can be purchased through Monarch Watch, a nonprofit organization focused on the monarch butterfly, its habitat, and the spectacular fall migration. Monarch Watch organizes tagging and related research, as well as distributes healthy milkweed plugs for habitat establishment or restoration. When tags come in the mail, you'll notice they are very small, alphanumerically coded stickers. If placed correctly, they are in fact non-invasive to butterflies' flight. Tags also come with a data sheet, which will ask that you write down the tag's code, release location, butterfly gender, and whether the butterfly was reared or wild. Wild butterflies, of course, can be caught with a butterfly net. The most obvious way to tell males from females is to look at their wings. Males have two pheromone sacs that look like black dots and have thinner black lines on the wings overall. Females tend to be larger and have thicker black lines on their wings with no black spots. When you're ready to handle your butterfly, be sure your hands are clean. Rubbing off too many scales or depositing oils and dirt onto their wings can hurt them. I like to have my tag ready with a pair of tweezers to move quickly during the tagging process. The less you handle the butterfly, the better. In my experience, it's best to first let the butterfly crawl onto the inside of your index finger. This gives them something to hold onto and prevents movements of struggle that can end up hurting them. It also distributes much of the butterfly's weight onto a solid surface, which prevents damage to the wings. Next, you want to quickly and gently pinch the wings together at an area close to the body of the monarch. Again, this distributes weight properly to prevent wing damage. As I mentioned before, it's very important to make sure you release the butterfly to an area full of good first food sources. Hopefully in the coming months, the tag code of one of your butterflies will be reported from Mexico through Monarch Watch. One of the district's priorities is native plant and pollinator health. And monarch education and research is one of the ways in which we can convey this to the public, as well as prioritize areas for restoration and habitat establishment. I hope you enjoyed this brief series on monarchs, and if you have any more questions, feel free to contact me at the district.